The Indian Army is the only army in the world that fights terrorism using exactly the same weapons that the terrorists use. The terrorists will use an AK-47, the Indian Army uses an AK-47. The terrorists may use an RPG, the Indian Army uses a rocket launcher, and so on and so forth. Look at what is happening in our immediate neighborhood. Look at Pakistan. After the very unfortunate attacks on APS Peshawar, in which more than 120 or 130 school children were killed, within 24 hours, Pakistan launched airstrikes using F-16 fighter aircraft on its own population. Now, these are not accurate weapons. These are not specific weapons. These are area weapons. So you see, no country in the world, including our immediate neighbor Pakistan, including China, we are being more than fair. I think the Indian Army is more than fair. People like Arundhati Roy, they will go to Dal Lake, they will go to Srinagar, they will meet separatists, and suddenly a Kashmir expert is born. And that Kashmir expert has the God-given right to spout nonsense, speak whatever they wish on social media, on mainstream media, and the media is very happy to cover it. I think the media should check the antecedents of the people who make such comments. They say that duniya mein qatil ussa munafiq nahi koi jo zulm to sehta hai bagawat nahi karta. It is our moral duty to fight against wrong, and that is what we are doing. We are countering malicious narrative which has been going on for 68 long years. It's very easy, you know, for some unknown nobody to come out of nowhere, cast aspersions on the fair name of the Indian Army, literally abuse the chief of the army staff, calling him General Dyer, and suddenly what do you have? You have stardom for free. Suddenly you become the darling of the left-leaning intelligentsia of this country. You become the darling of certain sections of the mainstream media. And what have you paid for it? You paid nothing. It's free of cost. All you need to do is abuse the Indian Army. And that is what these people have been doing. They must be countered. They have to be countered. I think there is also amongst the Indian bureaucracy, there is this fear of the unknown. They don't understand the Indian Army. It is a highly disciplined force. The Indian Army will not make a loose comment. They will not comment on things which are going on, perhaps an operation, perhaps a problem with the civilian administration. The army never comments. And I think the silence has been taken for granted by too many people. When the NIA conducted this series of raids across Kashmir, also Sonipat, also Delhi, you can't just have counter-insurgency operations without targeting the source of the funds. How are these funds generated? Because everybody needs to be paid. Nobody is doing it for free. The terrorist who's storming an army camp is not doing it for free. The stone pelter who's throwing stones is not doing it for free. The Hurriyat certainly is not doing it for free. Nobody is doing it for free. It requires vast sums of money. The NIA raids have proved that people from all religions are involved. People will do anything for money. Here, the target is money. So, you have a lot of cattle, goats being brought from Rajasthan into Kashmir, because mutton is a very large part of the Kashmiri diet, and also the carpet industry in Kashmir, the dry fruit industry in Kashmir. A lot of these people do invoicing fraud, and that is how money is made. So typically, for something that costs 50 lakh rupees, they will pay 2 crore rupees and then get back that 1.5 crore rupees, or maybe 1.25 crore rupees after giving that man his cut and after making sure that he's comfortable. And this money is distributed among terrorist groups. This money is distributed amongst stone pelters. And this is how it keeps on going, which is why it is very important. I think it's a very positive step that the government has taken, in which, you know, they have said that parallel to fighting terrorism, it is also important to fight and choke terror funding. This is the first step to choke terror funding.
Half of the time Kashmir is under band, under lockdown. Half of the time they are stone pelting. फिर भी कोई malnutrition का केस नहीं है, फिर भी कोई farmer suicide नहीं है. सबके गाल ऐसे लाल लाल गुलाबी हो रखे हैं वहाँ पे. I want to understand, where is this money coming from?
When I made this comment about the gulabi girl, I got a lot of flack from Kashmir. You know, a lot of people send messages on Facebook and on Twitter saying that you're jealous because Kashmiris are so fair and good looking. I said, you're fair and good looking, God bless you. But that is not the point. You know, in that entire debate, you've got just one piece, one small piece, a small part of a sentence, and you're playing it up. You know, the main thing is, where is the money coming from? How do you survive in Maharashtra, in Telangana, in Andhra Pradesh, which are, by the way, well-to-do states? There are farmer suicides when there is failure of monsoon, when farmers cannot pay back the loans that they take from local loan sharks. Have you heard of such a case in Kashmir? No. Where is this money coming from? That is what I want to ask the separatists. This is my question. The point is not whether you're fair and beautiful. If you're fair and beautiful, God bless you. Good for you. लेकिन ये हराम का पैसा कहां से आ रहा है? इसका जवाब किसी ने नहीं दिया। और यही हमें सवाल का जवाब ढूंढना है। और NIA जो है, वो भी यही सवाल का जवाब ढूंढने गई थी श्रीनगर, दिल्ली, सोनीपत। ये हराम का पैसा आ कहां से रहा है? कौन दे रहा है पैसा? Who's keeping this entire so-called आजादी कॉमेडी अफ्लोट? Who's funding it? मैं कश्मीर के उस हर संगबाज से मुखातिब हूं जो पैसा लेके पत्थर फेंकता है। ये जो आपको पैसे मिलते हैं, आपको मालूम हो कि हराम की कमाई है। और हराम की कमाई क्यों है? अगर आप अपनी हरकत से किसी को चोट पहुंचाते हैं और उसके लिए आपको पैसे मिलते हैं, ये कमाई हराम की है। ये आपको पता होना चाहिए। और आपको ये भी पता होना चाहिए कि आपका दीन इसकी बिल्कुल भी इजाजत नहीं देता। Many people have commented that the Indian Army is getting increasingly more aggressive in Kashmir. But that is the nature of armies everywhere. General Bipin Rawat leads 1.3 million warriors. These people, the officers and men of the Indian Army, are trained to kill the enemies of the state. They are not social workers. The Indian Army is the last argument of the state. And the last argument of the state is always like a hammer, because beyond the Indian Army, there is nothing.